Hello everyone. Yes, as Pier Giorgio said, I am a cryptographic researcher at Aragon ZK Research. We are a guild of the Aragon DAO doing research about cryptographic protocol. I myself come from academy, so my talk will be maybe the most boring of all. Okay, it works, yes? Okay. So, okay, so I will talk today about, let's say, timed privacy. Okay, so maybe you heard about, there is a lot of research now going on timed time lock encryption. And maybe you know about this guy. Who knows about him? He's Timothy May, was the founder of the crypto anarchist movement. And I think was also one of the creator of the cyberpunk mailing list. So in this message of 93, about 30 years ago, he proposed what he called timed release crypto service. So essentially this was a service, he proposed a service to encrypt data to the future. Okay, and in the same message also proposed many applications. We will cover some of them, let's say, in a more modern terminology later. So I am very proud that after 30 years, exactly 30 years, we at Aragon ZK Research, we are doing a lot of work to deploy the first time lock public service that actually somehow implemented the pioneering idea of Timothy May in a distributed way. We will see it soon. So how it works. So it works in this way. We will publish, for example, today, the public key of today, of tomorrow, three days in the future, for example, for the next 2 years. You can take today the public key of Christmas, and you can encrypt with respect to Christmas. So it's like you can send a message to Christmas. Okay. So on the day of Christmas, anybody will be able to decrypt. But before that day, your message is protected. We'll discuss soon what are the trust assumptions under our protocol. And moreover, the nice feature of our protocol that differentiates us from concurrent works is that our protocol is generic. For example, there are other time lock encryption systems that are very specific. Let's say they are ad hoc protocols. Okay, so if you want to do application with them, you should re-implement them, I don't know, in Python, Rust, in Java, in all of your applications. Instead, our protocol is generic in that, for example, we publish a generic public key of the Bitcoin Ethereum curve, SECP256K1. So it's the public key that we would normally use to encrypt in your favorite cryptographic library, like Rust, like Java Bouncy Castle, Python, and so on. So you don't need any change to your code. Everything started in a project related to e-voting that we worked on this project with Aztec that was mentioned before. So there was the Nanus DAO who asked to implement an anonymous voting solution for their DAO, and our solution was selected. So one of the main requirements for the anonymous voting solution that they wanted was fairness. Fairness means that the partial tally of the election should not be visible before the end of the election, because the problem of many anonymous voting solutions, especially the ones based on zero-knowledge proof, is that the partial tally is visible. For example, if 9 people casted a vote for yes, I am the 10th, I can lean, for example, to follow the majority and also to cast a vote for yes. Okay, so you really need, fairness is a really, really important property. And there are other proposed solutions based on threshold cryptography that we discarded. Why? Because threshold cryptography needs a committee that is always online, especially after the election. You need to request that they run an infrastructure to implement the threshold cryptography, and there were also other time lock encryption solutions, but for example, for the problem, they were a very ad hoc solution. To use them in our zero knowledge solution, we would need essentially zero knowledge circuit that compute various heavy operations like bilinear pairing and stuff like that. We did the test, it's like prove running almost in 1 hour, CRS of several hundred gigabytes, and so on. Okay, instead, our solution is generic, so you could select as public key zero knowledge friendly elliptic curve like baby jab jab, and the solution becomes more efficient. So, as I said, our solution is generic in that we support many elliptic curves, and here there is a list. Currently, we just in our testnet we support 2 curves, but we are going to support many more curves, and especially we don't require any multi-party computation procedure at decryption time. So how it works? Okay, so Timothy May proposed this timed release crypto protocol. His idea was based on traditional trust assumption. You have a server, you know, that publish key and the corresponding secret key. This is not ideal in the era of distributed computing. What path you could take? The next path you could take is the following. You make his idea distributed. What is the problem? The problem is that you need essentially trusted entities. No? Even if you go to a distributed set, you need the nodes to run the system. For example, we are not as famous as NIM. We are not as famous as the Ethereum Foundation. Okay? So this would be a problem for us to make any solution distributed. You need to find a partner to run the nodes, and there should be many nodes, famous partners, and so on. So what we did is that there was an already existing service called the League of Entropy. There's a service that publishes, now I think, each 3 seconds, a random beacon. So pure randomness each 3 seconds. Okay, and this service is already running, I think, since 3 years. And you can see here, it consists of many respectable partners, like Cloudflare, Kudelsk Security, University of Chile, about 25 partners. Okay, and it's completely independent from us. So our trust assumptions are the following. We have 2 trust assumptions. So first assumption is that League of Entropy, the majority of League of Entropy members, is honest. Okay, and this is safe because it's independent from us and it consists of many respectable partners. The second assumption is that we will have our own collision, okay? So, but the nice thing is that our protocol, the second trust assumption is that with one honest party among our collision. So for example, if you don't trust us, for example, you say, oh, who is Aragon ZK Research? We don't know them, we don't trust them. So you can join our coalition and you will be the honest party. So now I will present some application, some of the many applications of time lock cryptography and especially of our service. By the way, I forgot to mention our service will be called timelock.zone. We have a website you can already visit. So a natural application is automatic declassification of documents. You have nowadays government who promise to declassify document after X years. So if they promise that, they could directly publish the time lock encryption of such document with the date of X year in advance. So automatically the citizen will have access to the declassified document after X years. Another application is the following. Suppose that you are an activist that you fearing to be killed or to be kidnapped. Okay, so what you could do? What you could do is that you could time lock encrypt the password of your email, okay, with the date of 1 month in advance, for example. So if you are killed, okay, and then you spread the resulting ciphertext to other activists, your friends, the participant in your community, and so on. So if you are killed, after 1 month, the other activist will have access to your email because automatically the ciphertext will will be the, they will be able to uncover your password and will have access to your email. But if you are not killed, you will just change your password and you will redo the procedure. So you will encrypt again with the time lock your password and so on. So another application that actually was already put in practice is public disclosure, for example, of software bugs. Okay, so for example, you find a major bugs in Microsoft Windows. You can inform Microsoft and say, hey, Microsoft, I publish now this bug, I encrypt it with time lock zone with 1 month in advance. So it's a way to incentivize Microsoft to address the bug. Okay, because they know that if they don't address the bug, everybody will read the bug in 1 month. Another more technical application is what I call deniable timed signature. So suppose, for example, that at time T1 now, for example, an activist that I call Joe wants to send to everybody a message saying, let's meet, I don't know, let's meet on Rome on such date, okay? So other activists should have a proof that this message is authenticated by Joe, so there should be a signature. But what Joe can do is the following. He could produce a special signature, essentially proving this. I signed M, so this message, for example, let's meet in Rome on such a date, with either the time lock zone secret key of time T2, for a time T2, for example, 1 week in the future, or the message is signed with my secret key. So as byproduct, this is what implies that before time T2, so this statement consists of 2 ors. Okay, the first part, the first or is I signed the message with the time lock zone secret key of time T2 that is not available yet before time T2. So the first part of the or cannot be satisfied before time T2. Okay, so if someone produces a valid signature, it's because this message was signed by Joe. Okay, so other activists will say, oh yes, this message was signed by Joe, let's meet on Rome. After time T2, it's like the signature is pure garbage because everyone could simulate this signature using the time lock zone secret key of time T2. So what the activists can do, they can store on their computer fake signature of different messages. Let's meet on Lisbon or Rome and so on. So if the authority or their enemies, they will get in their computer after time T2, they will not have any proof of where and when the activists have met. So yeah, we have a roadmap. We have actually a functional prototype with a small number of nodes, including a university in Rome. We have a website, and we are selecting additional members. So if anyone is interested in joining our coalition, please contact us, because the resources needed to run our protocol are very light. So, but more trusted parties, there are batteries, okay? And we hopefully think that we can be production ready by the beginning of next year. We already did some application based on it. So the idea is that we did this application just to show how it's easy to build a time lock zone application. For example, we did a simple application, Windows integration, to encrypt files to the future. You right click on any file in Windows, you are prompted to choose a date, and the file is encrypted with that date, and on that date you can decrypt it. We have an Android app. And we also did a nice experiment. We ran an experiment in which there is a plugin for Outlook by the OpenPGP people. It's called GPGOL, and we were able to tweak it to send emails to the future. So yeah, just to show how it is easy to build time lock zone apps. So encrypting without time lock zone, essentially, because this is Java, okay, but you can choose your favorite language. Encrypting without time lock zone, essentially you just need to take the public key from some source, in this case a file. Okay, with time lock zone, we'll just have an API to convert your date to what we call round, because it's the round corresponds to the round of League of Entropy, so it's an increasing integer essentially. And then from our API, you will download the public key of that round. That's all. So this is the only difference. From that part onward, when you get the public key, the code will look identical in any programming language, Java, Rust, Python, JavaScript. We did experiment in essentially the major programming languages and framework, including IoT devices. So that's all. If you have any questions, we can talk offline. Thanks.